Today's topic of discussion is cell wall and cell organelle. We are going to concentrate on cell wall today, and in next lecture we go to the cell organelle. As we know that cell wall is the most important protective layer in the living organism. Cell wall is the external covering which is present to the cell. So it acts as a protective layer. Now, as we talk about the cell wall or the term cell wall is used as a protective structure in most of the plant, not only in plant but also in bacteria, in fungi, in algae and other organisms also, there is a presence of this protective layer. We call it as a wall. It is a dead and rigid layer called wall. It is protective, but it is a dead part, and hence it acts as a protection for the living organism. The term wall was first used by Robert Hooke in 1665. As we know that cell is also discovered by the Robert Hooke, the same thing, wall or the cell wall was first termed by Hooke in 1665. It is mainly composed of carbohydrates such as cellulose, pectin, hemicellulose and lignin, and certainly fatty substances like waxes are also present in as a cell wall. So when we talk about carbohydrates, we know that carbohydrates is having a different types. Say for example, it is a cellulose, hemicellulose, then dextrose, all these are nothing but the carbohydrate or types of carbohydrate. But mainly cell wall is made up of cellulose. Now the question is there, what is mean by cellulose? Cellulose is the polymer of sugar. So one sugar combined to other combined to another one, likewise they form the chain, and that's why they are called as a polymer. So they shows the chain of sugar, and this chain of sugar is known as cellulose. Likewise, pectin is also the chain of sugar, hemicellulose is there, lignin is there, and along with that certain fatty acids or fatty substances like waxes are also present as a cell wall. बरेच वेळा आपण प्लांट्स बघतो आणि प्लांट्सवर असं कवरिंग आल्यासारखं आपल्याला दिसतं, वॅक्सी कवरिंग आपल्याला दिसतं, वॅक्स सारखं कवर दिसतं, अँड दॅट कवरिंग इज नथिंग बट दी फॅटी सबस्टन्सेस विच ॲक्ट ॲज अ पार्ट ऑफ सेल वॉल विच फंक्शन फॉर दी प्रोटेक्शन. नाऊ वेन वी गो फॉर दी अल्ट्रा स्ट्रक्चर, मीन्स वेन वी गो फॉर दी डिटेल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द सेल वॉल, इट इज फाउंड दॅट इट इज कन्सिस्ट ऑफ मायक्रो फायब्रिलर नेटवर्क lying in gel like matrix. So again there is a gel like matrix, and in that gel like matrix the microfibrils, sadhya bhashet sangaycha tar fibers, ashe fibers aplyala tya gel like matrix madhe distil, tyalach apan cell wall asa mhanto. So there is a fibers, and that fibers is lying in a gel like matrix, so that we called it as a cell wall. There is a pectin rich cementing substance between the wall of adjacent cell which called middle lamella. Now when we look for the two cells, in between two cells there is a small gap, and that small gap we called it as a middle lamella. So sadhya bhashet sangaycha tar don bhintichya kiwa don room cha madhe ji bhint aste tyala apan middle lamella asu mhanu, cell wall आणि सेल वॉल नंतर मिडल लॅमेला. तर दोन सेलच्या मध्ये जी जागा असते त्या जागेला आपण मिडल लॅमेला असं म्हणू शकतो. द सेल वॉल विच इज फॉर्म्ड इमिजिएटली आफ्टर द डिव्हिजन ऑफ सेल कॉन्स्टिट्यूट्स द प्रायमरी सेल वॉल. आता जेव्हा एका सेलपासून दुसरी सेल तयार होते सेल डिव्हिजनच्या प्रोसेसमध्ये, तेव्हा जी पहिली लेयर तयार होते सेल वॉलची, त्या पहिल्या लेयरला प्रायमरी सेल वॉल असं म्हटलं जातं. Means we can say that there is a two types of cell wall. The first one is primary cell wall and another one is the secondary cell wall. primary cell wall is the cell wall which is first produced, and secondary cell wall is the wall which is produced in the later development. So primary cell wall is there first and then secondary cell wall is there. Now here you will get the clear cut idea of the middle lamella. So here you can see there is a middle lamella. This one is the middle lamella, which is the space between two cells. This is cell 1. So this one is the cell 1 and this is cell, suppose cell 3. So in between the cell 1 and cell 3, you can get a small space is there. That space is known as middle lamella. Now along with middle lamella, you can observe here there is a connection between two cells. So cell 1 is connected with the cell 2 with the particular parameter, we called it as a plasmodesmata. So plasmodesmata is there. This plasmodesmata can form the bridge between cell 1 and cell 3. So suppose cell 1 wants to send some message or send some material from cell 1 to cell 3, this plasmodesmata is utilized or used to transfer some material from cell 1 to cell 3. The same plasmodesmata is again present in between cell 2 and cell 3. So likewise, the all different cell present in a plant, we can say, they shows the presence of plasmodesmata, and this plasmodesmata helps in the transfer of material or message from one cell to another cell. Many kind of plant cell have only primary cell wall around them. Primary cell wall is composed of pectin, hemicellulose and loose network of cellulose microfibril. In certain type of cells such as phloem and xylem, an additional layer is added to the inner surface of the primary cell wall at later stage. This layer is known as secondary wall, and it consists mainly of cellulose, hemicellulose and lignin. In many plant cells, there are tunnel through which or through the cell wall called plasmodesmata, which allows communication with each other with other cell in the organism. So this is nothing but a short description. Again here you can see there is a presence of middle lamella in between two cell. Then there is a presence of plasmodesmata as a tunnel in two cell. Along with that, here you can observe the primary cell wall, which is present external to the cell. So this is the cell 1, and cell 1 is having the external cell wall, we called it as a primary cell wall. Along with that, you can observe that there is another types of cell wall, we called it as a secondary cell wall. So these three parameters comprises of the secondary cell wall. What are they? They are secondary cell wall called as S1, which is very external, then secondary cell wall S2 and secondary cell wall S3. These are nothing but the three parameters in a secondary cell wall. They are produced after the primary cell wall. म्हणजे पहिले प्रायमरी सेल वॉल तयार होईल सेलची, आणि त्याच्यानंतर मग डेव्हलपमेंट झाल्यानंतर सेलमध्ये सेकंडरी सेल वॉल तिथे तयार होईल. त्या सेकंडरी सेल वॉलमधले तीन पार्ट्स असतात, S1, S2 आणि S3. आता S1, S2, S3 काय आहे ते आपण पुढच्या स्लाईडमध्ये बघू. प्रायमरी सेल वॉल. प्रायमरी सेल वॉल इज थिन, फ्लेक्झिबल अँड एक्सटेन्सिबल. It is made up of cellulose, pectin, hemicellulose, and its primary cell wall is permeable. Now, as we talk about the primary cell wall, it is very thin and flexible. Thin, we know very well, it is very thin layer and it is a flexible. That's why cell can change the shape and it shows the flexibility. Then it is permeable. Now what is the mean of permeable? Permeable means it is, or the cell wall allows substances to transfer from one place to another place. Now here, so suppose this is the cell wall, and these are suppose some molecules which is present to the outer side. Now what this primary cell wall do? This primary cell wall allows these particular particles, this material, to penetrate through this particular and go to the inner side of the cell wall. So this, that's why it is known as permeable. So the primary cell wall act as a permeable. There is another type of transfer mechanism is there, or we can say another type of cell wall is also there, that is we called it as a semi-permeable, non-permeable, but the primary cell wall is permeable and it allows material to go from outer side to the inner side of the cell. Now moving to the next, that is secondary cell wall. Secondary cell wall is thick, present inside the primary wall. It is made up of cellulose, hemicellulose and lignin. As we discussed in earlier slide that S1, S2 and S3 is there, that S1, S2 and S3 is nothing but the cellulose, hemicellulose and lignin. These three molecules will combine with each other and they forms the secondary cell wall. And due to the inclusion of these three molecules, cellulose, hemicellulose and lignin, it will become thick. And as we know earlier, that secondary cell wall lies inside to the primary cell wall. So suppose here, this is the suppose primary cell wall. After this primary cell wall, what happens? This secondary cell wall appears. So first this particular primary cell wall appears, and later on development the secondary cell wall will appear. Now moving to the next parameter, that is prokaryotic cell wall. As we know that bacteria also possesses the cell wall, but in bacteria two types of cell wall is observed. Say for example, here you can clearly get the difference between gram positive bacteria and gram negative bacteria. There is two types of bacteria, gram positive bacteria and gram negative bacteria. So what is the difference between gram positive and gram negative bacteria? So when we talk about gram positive bacteria, you can clearly observe that there is a peptidoglycan which is very thick layer. And this peptidoglycan layer in gram-negative bacteria is very thin. So here you can observe the layer, we called it as a peptidoglycan. So this is the peptidoglycan layer which is very thick in gram-positive, and in gram-negative it is very thin. Along with this, you can observe that there is outer membrane in gram-negative bacteria, whereas this outer membrane is absent in a gram positive bacteria. Now in both gram positive and gram negative bacteria, you can observe the periplasmic space. Periplasmic space is the space between two walls, peptidoglycan and internal plasma membrane. In between these two, there is a space. That space is known as periplasmic space. It is present in both gram positive and gram negative bacteria. After a periplasmic space, there is a presence of plasma membrane, and after a plasma membrane, there is a presence of cytoplasm. So we have to concentrate on this particular parameter, that is peptidoglycan, and this particular, as it is the part of cell wall. So in gram positive bacteria, peptidoglycan is thick layer, and in gram negative bacteria, peptidoglycan is very thin. And along with that, there is a presence of outer membrane which is made up of lipopolysaccharides and porins. These are the polysaccharides, and these lipopolysaccharides and porins produce outer covering in gram-negative bacteria. So this is nothing but the prokaryotic cell wall. Now talking about the eukaryotic cell wall, consists of polysaccharides, chitin and polymer, that is cellulose. So chitin and cellulose, these are the polymers which is present in a cell wall of eukaryotes. they are linked with beta-1,4 linkage. समजा हा सेल्युलोज आहे आणि हा सेल्युलोज आहे, या दोघांमध्ये जे काही कनेक्शन असतं, लिंकेज असतं, त्या लिंकेजला beta-1,4 लिंकेज असं म्हटलं जातं. त्याचं एक्झाम्पल जर सांगायचं तर फंगल सेल वॉल. फंगल सेल वॉलमध्ये चिटिन असतो आणि सेल्युलोज असतो. चिटिन आणि सेल्युलोज दोघांमध्ये beta-1,4 लिंकेज होऊन दोन मॉलिक्यूल एकत्र जोडल्या जातात. अशा प्रकारे हे मॉलिक्यूल एकमेकांना जोडून जोडून तिथे चिटिन नावाचा किंवा फंगल सेल वॉल जी आहे ती बनलेली असते. प्लांट अँड अल्गल सेल वॉल कंपोज्ड ऑफ सेल्युलोज, म्हणजे प्लांट्स आणि अल्गीचा जर आपण विचार केला तर आपल्याला असं लक्षात येईल की दोघांमध्ये सेल्युलोज हा पॉलिसॅकेराइड आहे आणि त्याच्यामुळे सेल वॉल बनलेली आहे. बट वेन वी टॉक अबाउट ॲनिमल सेल, सेल वॉल इज अब्सेंट इन ॲनिमल सेल. सो दॅट इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टंट पॅरामीटर रिगार्डिंग युकॅरियोटिक सेल. नाउ मूव्हिंग टू द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टंट पार्ट, दॅट इज फंक्शन ऑफ सेल वॉल. नाउ ॲज वी टॉक अबाउट सेल वॉल, सेल वॉल इज द प्रोटेक्टिव्ह लेअर अँड इट प्रोटेक्ट्स द सेल फ्रॉम एक्स्टर्नल चेंजेस. से फॉर एक्झाम्पल, जर खूप थंडी पडली असेल किंवा खूप गर्मी असेल किंवा आणखी काही खूप पाऊस असेल किंवा आणखी काही फिजिकल पॅरामीटर असतील, फिजिकल इफेक्ट्स असतील, त्या फिजिकल इफेक्ट्सपासून प्रोटेक्शन करण्याचं काम सेल वॉल करतं. इवन आपली बॉडीसुद्धा सेल वॉलनी प्रोटेक्ट आहे. बरोबर की चूक? ओके. आपणसुद्धा ॲनिमल आहे आणि ॲनिमलमध्ये सेल वॉल अब्सेंट आहे, त्यामुळे आपण असं म्हणू शकतो की इन ह्युमन ऑल्सो सेल वॉल इज अब्सेंट. एनिवे, प्लांट इज हॅविंग सेल वॉल अँड सेल वॉल ॲक्ट ॲज अ प्रोटेक्टिव्ह लेअर. इट विल प्रोटेक्ट, सो प्रोव्हाइडिंग मेकॅनिकल स्ट्रेंथ, सपोर्ट अँड रिजिडिटी टू द सेल, दॅट इज द फर्स्ट फंक्शन. कोणत्याही सेलला रिजिडिटी मिळण्यासाठी, प्रॉपर शेप मिळण्यासाठी, एक पर्टिक्युलर स्ट्रेंथ मिळण्यासाठी त्याला सेल वॉलची गरज असते. सेल वॉल ऑल्सो प्रोव्हाइड शेप टू द प्लांट्स ऑर ॲनिमल, इवन ॲनिमल वी कॅन से, इवन टू द बॅक्टेरियल सेल, द शेप इज प्रोव्हाइडेड बाय द सेल वॉल. जर सेल वॉल नसती सपोज, तर प्लांट्सला किंवा प्लांट्स सेलला किंवा बॅक्टेरियल सेलला एक शेप जो येतो तो शेप आपल्याला पाहायला मिळाला नसता. सेल वॉल अलाउज सिलेक्टिव एंट्री ऑफ स्मॉल मॉलिक्यूल इनसाइड द सेल वाईल प्रिव्हेंटिंग लार्ज मॉलिक्यूल. या सेल वॉल असल्यामुळे छोटे छोटे जे मॉलिक्यूल्स असतात ते मॉलिक्यूल्स सेलच्या आत जाऊ शकतात, पण मोठा जर मॉलिक्यूल असेल किंवा मोठा एखादं मटेरियल असेल ते मोठं मटेरियल आत जाऊ देणार नाही किंवा जाणार नाही. त्याला आपण सिलेक्टिवली परमिएबल असं सुद्धा म्हणू शकतो. सो इट विल प्रिव्हेंट द लार्ज मॉलिक्यूल, वेअर ॲज अ व्हेरी स्मॉल मॉलिक्यूल कॅन पेनिट्रेट थ्रू द सेल वॉल. प्रोटेक्टिंग द डेलिकेट इनर ऑर्गेनेल फ्रॉम द आउटर शॉक्स. मी आता सांगितलं की हीट असेल, कोल्ड असेल, या सगळ्यांपासून सेलचं प्रोटेक्शन, सेलमधल्या ऑर्गेनेल्सचं प्रोटेक्शन करायचं काम हा सेल वॉल करत असतो. सो प्रोटेक्शन इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टंट पॅरामीटर. प्रोव्हाइडिंग टर्जिडिटी टू द प्लांट्स दॅट अलाउज मूवमेंट ऑफ वॉटर अँड मिनरल थ्रू द प्लांट बॉडी. प्लांट सेलला एक टर्जिडिटी देण्याचं कामसुद्धा सेल वॉल करतं आणि त्याच्यामुळे वेगवेगळे मेकॅनिझम जे आहेत, मूवमेंट ऑफ वॉटर म्हणजे पाणी रूटपासनं टॉपपर्यंत जाण्याचं जे काम असतं, हे सगळं करण्याचं काम सेल वॉलमुळे होतं. सो हिअर वी स्टॉप विथ दी सेल वॉल. इन नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू कॉन्सन्ट्रेट ऑन दी सेल ऑर्गेनेल्स.